There are those we share something with. and those we don't seem to share anything with.
Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the evidence. Yes or no? Guilty or innocent? Black or white? Stuck to the
Mm-hmm. Start until everyone has found their places. The ones at the top sitting in the last rows prefer to have an overview of the performance. This option is to be considered especially optimal with dance performances. From this perspective, one can easily follow the alteration of the space and that of the movement patterns. From here, one can behold the whole space with a single glimpse. The bird's eye view is for those who don't want to miss out on anything. The ones sitting in the center are those who want to benefit from both of the aforementioned positions, who want it all at once. For those in the first or last row, this might well seem like a compromise. He thinks about what to say. Lights down. We hear a voice. He just talks, talks, talks. He doesn't tell a story. Instead, he tells us exactly what is happening in the moment. He then wraps up. He finishes. Lights up. The protagonist stands up stage center, where the black and white dance floors meet. He waits for the perfect moment. Lights down. Lights up. The protagonist stands up stage center, where the black and white dance floors meet. He waits. He thinks it still would be too soon to act. Blackout. Lights up. The protagonist walks upstage center where the black and white dance floors meet. He knows what he wants to say, but he doesn't say it yet.
Blackout.
Purposefully drive past. People facelessly walk by. My feet mindlessly move across the pavement. My body present, but inside me is not. All around, life is living, but I'm dying. Every cell in my body consumed with no longer wanting to exist. No point in carrying on. The emotional pain, larger than life allows. My very existence screaming for the pain to go. Somewhere, my unconscious mind is telling me that it's time to cross the road. I reach the pavement edge and then, as my automated self steps to move into the streams of traffic, my conscious mind kicks in. I suddenly know that I don't want to leave this existence. My auto move makes my feet step off the curb edge. I also know that by continuing to exist as I'm feeling, I'm living an emotional, despair-filled life sentence. My body weaves between the rushing cars as I move into the middle of the road. Then, certainty hits me. I really only have ever had two choices. To live a long and overwhelming life filled with angst. I continue to navigate between the other lane of traffic moving in the other direction.
By all my childish fears, and if you have to
having already packed.
I
said goodbye to my wife and son the night before, so I just hopped in.
Like my voice was hoarse from last night.
From the Amazonas.
I tried to speak,
but... that time of the morning.
Never my book, except we never had one around here. I don't think.
Or they didn't hear. I'm at its secret center. Lives death.
I found a feather.
I found a feather.
I found a feather.
I found a little boy's shoe.